this video, we're going to take a closer look at diffraction and interference. We've looked at different sorts of waves. Waves on a string, waves in the air, light waves, and water waves. All these waves have two things in common. They bend around barriers, and when they have overlap, they combine into a new wave. When a wave bends around a barrier, that's called diffraction. And when waves mix together, that's called interference. All waves can diffract and interfere. One way to see diffraction and interference in action is to send a wave through a narrow slit and look at the wave pattern that appears on the other side. When you send a wave through a single slit onto a screen, you get a pattern of bright areas on the screen, called maxima. That alternates with areas of dark, called minima. Why does sending a wave through a single slit cause this pattern? Diffraction allows the wave to cover a much larger area of the screen than you would expect. Interference occurs because each point of a wave behaves as a separate wave source. This is known as the Huygens Principle. The yellow dots in this image represent those individual points, called wavelets. This means that these independently behaving waves will interact on the screen, some in phase with one another, producing maxima, and some out of phase, producing minima. The peaks and valleys appear so regularly, we can fit them into an equation. When the width of the slit is much smaller than the distance to the screen, and the wavelength of the wave passing through the slit is much smaller than the width of the slit, the wave doesn't bend much after passing through the single slit. When this is the case, we can approximate the position of dark spots, or minima, on the screen using this equation. Y sub min equals L times lambda times M divided by A. Y sub min is the distance on the screen from the intensity minimum being considered to the center of the main peak. L is the distance from the slit to the screen. Lambda is the wavelength of the incoming wave, and M is a whole number, called the order number, telling which minimum we are referring to. M can be positive or negative, depending on whether you are looking at minima to the left or right of the central maximum. Finally, A is the width of the slit the wave passes through. This is the equation for minima from a single slit. On the other hand, if our setup has two slits, the equation for intensity maxima, rather than minima, is the same, where Y sub max equals L times lambda times M divided by B. All the variables in this equation are the same as those in the single slit equation, except for B, which is the distance between the two slits. We'll use both the single and double slit relationships to study wave effects in action. For our first example, consider the single slit setup. Our wavelength is 1 meter, the slit width is 150 meters, and the backdrop is 2,300 meters behind the slit. How far above the center of the screen is the first minimum point in the pattern? We'll use the single slit equation we looked at above to answer this question. The distance of the first minimum point from the center line, y sub min, equals the distance from the slit to the backdrop, times the wavelength, divided by slit width, all multiplied by m. But what is m? Since we're asked about the distance of the first minimum point, we know that m is 1 in this case. We're solving for y sub min. Let's insert the values we know for the other parameters. L is the distance between the slit and the screen. That's given as 2,300 meters. Lambda, the wavelength of our wave, is 1 meter. And A, the width of the slit, we're told is 150 meters. So y sub min equals 2,300 meters times 1 meter times 1 divided by 150 meters. Which equals 15.3 meters. That means the first minimum in the wave interference pattern on the screen is 15.3 meters above the pattern's center. For an interference pattern made with sound waves, this minimum would be a dead spot, the absence of sound. Now we'll look at an example with a light wave, but remember, it's the same dynamics with any type of wave. In this case, we have two slits instead of one, so we'll use the double slit equation we looked at earlier. Green laser light with a wavelength of 545 nanometers shines on a surface with two slits spaced at 0.5 millimeters apart. The diffracted light waves mix and land on a screen behind the slits. Looking at the pattern of bright and dark spots created, take a ruler and measure the distance from the center of the pattern to the second bright spot above it. the distance is 6.0 millimeters. What is the distance between the slits and the screen? We want to solve for the distance L. So let's rearrange the equation so it says L equals something. Multiplying both sides of the equation by B and dividing both sides by M times lambda, we see the equation now reads L equals Y sub M times B divided by M times lambda. Now if we can find out and fill in the other parts of the equation, we'll be able to solve for L. Y sub max is the distance we measured, the position of the second bright spot above the center of the pattern, 6.0 millimeters, or 0.006 meters. B is the distance in meters between the two slits. That's 0.5 millimeters, or 5 times 10 to the negative 4th meters. Now, what's M? Remember, M is a whole number that tells us just which bright spot we're working with. The question stated that we measured the second bright spot above the interference pattern center. That means M equals positive 2 in this case. And finally, the wavelength lambda. We're given that value. It's 545 nanometers, which is 5.45 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. With all these numbers figured out, we enter them into the equation to solve for L. L equals 0.006 meters times 5.0 times 10 to the negative 4th meters divided by the quantity 2 times 5.45 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, which equals 2.8 meters. That's how far the screen needs to be behind the slits in order for a pattern like the one we measured to appear. For this third practice question, let's keep our light waves and double slit, but switch up a few things about the setup. In this situation, we shine a red laser with a wavelength of 560 nanometers on the two slits. We don't know how far apart the slits are from one another, but we do know they are 1.5 meters away from the screen behind them. We see another interference pattern on the screen, and this time measure the position of the third dark spot below the center point, measuring a distance of 7.5 millimeters. We want to figure out what's the distance between the two slits. Here's a start. We'll rely on the same relationship as in the last example. Knowing that, press pause and take a minute to see if you can answer this question. We'll start back when you're ready. Okay, did you find the distance between the slits is 0.28 millimeters? If so, great work. If not, let's solve it together. Once we know we'll use the double slit equation, we want to figure out what exactly we'd like to solve for. This question asks for the distance between the two slits. That's B. So we'll rearrange the double slit equation so it says B equals something. Multiplying both sides by B and dividing both sides by Y sub min, we get B equals M times L times lambda divided by Y sub min. Now, we'll want to figure out all the variables on the right side of the equation. We are looking for the third dark spot below the center. The equation we have been using for double slits has M as a positive or negative integer, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, and so forth. This is true for when we are looking for the distance to a bright spot. But what if we have or are looking for the distance to a dark spot to a minimum? In this case, the third dark spot, or third minimum below the central maximum, lies at a position where M is equal to minus 2.5. L, the distance between the slits and the screen, is given to be 1.5 meters. Lambda, the wavelength of the red laser, is 560 nanometers, or 5.6 times 10 to the negative 7 meters. And Y sub min, the position of the third dark spot, we measured to be 7.5 millimeters below the central maximum, or negative 0.0075 meters. Let's insert all these values into the equation for B. So B equals minus 2.5 times 1.5 meters times 5.65 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, all divided by negative 0.0075 meters, which equals 0.28 millimeters. That's how far apart the two slits are that would create this particular wave interference pattern. That's a closer look at diffraction and interference. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.